Hello and welcome to the channel. The Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, employed the services of Amazon Web Services, AWS, during the last election as host of INEC results viewing portal IREV, which was deployed in the conduct of the election. But employer and employee were in disagreement in court over the electoral body's popular line of technical glitches. Subscribe, like, share, and comment. Thank you. IREV, web engineer, Tinubu's legal team disagree on alleged Amazon server glitches. President Bola Tinubu, as through his legal team, told the Presidential Election Petition Court in Abuja that Amazon Web Services, AWS, server is prone to glitches, but a cloud and web engineer from the firm disagreed. AWS Incorporated hosts the INEC results viewing IREV portal, which was deployed in the conduct of Nigeria's disputed elections in 2023. AWS is a subsidiary of Amazon, an online store for assorted commodities with global patronage. An information technology management company, AWS provides on-demand cloud computing platforms to individuals, companies, and government agencies. The presidential candidates of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, Atiku Abubakar, and the Labour Party's Peter Obi, filed separate petitions to challenge the outcome of the poll. They both accused the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, of manipulating the results of the 25 February election to secure victory for Tinubu of the All Progressives Congress, APC. INEC's failure to upload the results in real time, as promised, was one of the early reasons opposition parties and their supporters criticized the elections in the wake of the conclusion of the exercise. The issue forms part of the grounds raised by Atiku and Mr. Obi in challenging Mr. Tinubu's victory in the disputed poll. The commission had tried to explain away the failure by blaming it on technical glitches suffered by the IREV portal as a result of network failure. But the web engineer from AWS, Mpe Oga, brought by Mr. Obi to testify in court on Monday, countered INEC's claim. Testifying before the five-member panel of the court, headed by Arunat Samani, Mrs. Oga said the IREV portal did not experience any technical issues to justify INEC's failure to upload real-time the polling unit results of the 25th February presidential election. Mr. Tinubu's lawyer, Wole Olanipekun, while cross-examining Mrs. Oga, asked the witness if she was aware that in 2021, AWS experienced 27 outages on its servers, to which she responded, no. Mr. Olanipekun, a senior advocate of Nigeria's son, went on to reference a glitch experienced by MTN Momo PSB Payment Service Bank on its server last year. The Momo Payment Service Bank Limited is a fintech subsidiary of MTN Nigeria. The technical hitch led to erroneous transfers of the bank's customers' funds. Upon further cross-examination, Mrs. Oga, a cloud engineer and architect at Amazon Web Services Incorporated, said it is. Highly unusual for glitches to occur for primary functions during production of AWS when it is available to end users. She told the court that her reports of the 33 regions where Amazon Web Services hosts their servers are available public information. The witness clarified that she was not at the court to testify as Amazon Web Services Incorporated official, but to testify as an expert witness regarding the technology that hosts INEC IREV. Mrs. Oga said she was a Labour Party candidate for the House of Representatives election in Cross River State. She admitted to losing the contest. While being cross-examined by Latif Agbemi, APC's lawyer, Mrs. Oga said nothing is impossible regarding glitches during the deployment of AWS technology. She earlier told the court at Tuesday's proceedings that glitches only happened during the testing stage of the AWS software. The court adjourned the suit until Wednesday for further hearing. Meanwhile, Mr. Obi is expected to close his case on Friday. Thereafter, Mr. Tinubu, INEC and the APC will commence their defense in the suit. Subscribe, like, share, comment, and please turn the notification bell on. Thank you. Meanwhile, recall that a witness of the Labour Party's presidential candidate, Peter Obi, told the Presidential Election Petition Court in Abuja that the INEC IREV portal did not experience any glitches to justify the failure to upload real-time the polling unit results of the 25th February presidential election. INEC had in a statement issued a day after the polls by its Commissioner for Voter Education, Festus Okoye, blamed unexpected technical glitches for the Commission's inability to ensure real-time uploading of results to IREV portal as provided in the guidelines for the election. Voting ended in most of the over 176,000 polling units where the election held across Nigeria on 25th February. But results remained inaccessible on the INEC IREV portal 24 hours after polling ended. Mr. Obi filed his petition at the Presidential Election Court to challenge the victory of President Bola Tinubu of the All Progressives Congress APC, citing the failure to upload the results of the election to IREV as one of the breaches that marred the disputed poll. He also alleged that INEC manipulated the polls in favor of Mr. Tinubu. But contrary to the electoral umpire's claim, Mr. Obi's seventh witness, Empe Oga, told the court that a report of the health status of the Amazon Web Services, which hosts INEC IREV portal, showed that there were no technical glitches on 25th February 2023. She adopted a witness statement on hold the post to on 19 June at the registry of the court. Mrs. Oga, a subpoenaed witness, tendered copies of her resume and appointment letter at Amazon Web Services Incorporated and 6-volume reports of the 33 regions where Amazon Web Services hosts their servers. But INEC, APC, and Mr. Tinubu objected to the admissibility of the documents. The 5-member panel of the court, headed by Aruna Tsamani, admitted and marked the documents as exhibits. After admitting the documents, the court adjourned the suit for cross-examination of Mrs. Oga. That's the news, guys. Thanks for listening. Until next time, bye.